everyone. Myself, Dr. Jaswinder Kaur, Assistant Professor in Engineering Chemistry, Department of Applied Sciences, IIMT Group of Colleges. Today's our topic is ion exchange process. This is also known as deionization or demineralization. In ion exchange process, actually it is used in industries for descaling. What is scales? Scales are basically the hard deposits which are caused due to the dissoluble salts of heavy metals like calcium, magnesium. And these salts just accumulated due to the long time evaporation of water. And due to this evaporation, it makes a hard layer on the surface of boilers. This may cause so many problems in boilers, like reducing heat. So it can decrease the efficiency of boilers. It can also use more fuel. The calorific value also decreases in this manner. So to reduce or to remove these problems, we just use ion exchange process. In ion exchange process, we use two types of resins. First resin is known as cation exchange resin. The another resin, this is known as anion exchange resin. In cation exchange resin, basically these are long chain cross-linked polymer compounds of styrene divinyl polymers. In this structure, you can see this is the polymer which is known as cation exchange resin. Here, there are some groups attached to this resin. These groups are known as functional groups. These groups are responsible to exchange the its H positive ions with the cations of impurities present in water. This may be calcium, magnesium, and so on. These functional groups may be sulfonic acid, may be carboxylic acids. After sulfonation or carboxylation, they become capable to exchange their H positive ions with the cations of water. Same in case of anion exchange resins. In anion exchange resin, there is a group. This group is the functional group of this anion exchange resin. Same group is attached here. And this group is basically due to the presence of amino or quaternary ammonium salt. These groups, amino or ammonium groups or salts, just react with NaOH and give us this type of groups. And this OH will then exchange the anionic or the negative ions of the water. For this, we have some reactions. In this, basically, we can say that this cation exchanger can be written as RH positive. If we write here this RH positive, we can use it for the exchange of cations from the water. It may be if it is calcium 2 plus. We have to use two molecules of RH plus and it will change into R2Ca2 plus and two H positives will be liberated out. Same in case of magnesium. If there is magnesium metal present in water, then we can write it here like this. This will be R2Mg2+, and again, two protons are liberated in the washings. Now, in the case of anion exchanger, as we are first, we have to pass our water from cation exchanger. Here, this reaction just carried out. After that, we have to go for another column, that is anion exchanger. For anion exchanger, the reaction will be here. We can write it like ROH negative, as it exchanges the anions of water. We can write here ROH negative. The anions of water can be written as chlorides. Chlorides, it will change RCl negative and OH ions will come out. Here the exchange is between OH negative or the hydroxide ions of resin, anion exchange resin with the anions of water. It may also be there for ROH negative with The another anionic components that may be sulfates. Sulfates may be there. Two molecules of resin is used for this, and it will change into, and again, two OH negative will just come out. Again, the another component, we can use carbonate. For carbonate, R2CO3 negative to minus plus 2OH negative. As you can see here that in all the reactions, as in cation exchanger, the two H positive or hydrogen ion just come out. And in case of anion exchangers, OH, that is hydroxide ions, just come out. So that these, after this process, when we just pass our water, the hard water, through cation exchanger and then anion exchanger, what we get? We get H positive and OH negative. And this H positive and OH negative just combine together to form water. So that we can say that after passing through anion on cation exchanger or these resins, the water comes out is purely, it is approximately pure water, pure H2O. There is no presence of any type of cations and anions now. Now, the another thing we have to discuss in this process is that regeneration. What is regeneration? When impure water is passed through cation exchanger and anion exchanger, what happens? The capability of exchanging H positive ions, that is hydrogen ions of cation exchanger, and the capability of exchanging OH negative ions of anion exchanger with the anions of water just lost. It is known as exhausted. The resins are now exhausted. So these resins now can be regenerated. The regeneration can be done by, as in case of cation exchanger, we just treat our exchanger with dilute HCl or dilute sulfuric acid. The reaction can be written as, this is our exhausted cation exchangers. We can just treat it with H positive, this HCl, just give it H positives. And the reaction will be, two H positive will be given here, and it will again change it to H positive. Yani, that is, your exchanger is now regenerated. As in case of anion exchanger, the capability of exchanging its OH ions with the anions of water is now lost. We can now regenerate it by just treating it with NaOH. We can just pass NaOH, this is our exhausted, we can say here, this is with sulfate or any chloride, we can say chloride. When RCl, we can just write it as RCl negative, when titrated with NaOH or NaOH is passed through this resin, it will just change into ROH negative and Cl negative will just will wash out. And again we will get this anion exchanger. So with this method we can reuse these exchangers. The process is very good, very much important for so many purposes, as in boiler, as well as for mineralization. But some of their advantages and disadvantages everywhere. For this, the advantage is that the water come out from this is totally demineralized or deionized water. This ion exchanger can just titrate the water of high alkalinity as well as high acidity. But some of disadvantages are also there. The main disadvantage is that this equipment is very expensive. The chemical which are used in this is, again, they are very expensive. Then the turbid water, with the water having very high turbidity level, it cannot be done properly by this ion exchange process. For this, first we have to coagulate this water, filtrate it, and then we can go for the ion exchange process. This was all about the ion exchange process. Thank you.